plastic recycling in Europe. It seems to many that plastic recycling in Europe is always super technological, super expensive and sophisticated enterprises. In fact, in Europe, recyclers with completely different business models coexist quite well. In this video, we will show you two examples, two completely different strategies for running this business. We are in Holland, Hengelo, at DePauw Rodepa company. This is an example of expensive European recycling, exactly as many imagined this. DePauw Rodepa is a group of companies with recycling facilities in Holland, Slovakia and Italy. Managing Director Mark Langenhoff. They recycle both post-industrial and post-consumer plastic waste, such as LDP, HDP and PP. They sell regranulate, regreened and also sorted, baled film and rigid plastic. According to the information, the group sells about 150,000 tons annually. Most of the products goes for export to Southeast Asia. As expected, many processes are mechanized and automated, as much as possible to minimize expensive employees. At the beginning of technological process, for processing the film, all incoming materials are rebaled in order to obtain a unified size, weight and quality in subsequent processes, and b to resell it in a unified form with maximum transport load. Dirty post-consumer film materials go to Herbert washing line with a capacity of up to 1000 kilos per hour. Washed and dry flakes are accumulated in the hopper and fed to the next recycling step for extrusion and pelletizing. Regranulation is carried out on three eremas with 1000 kilo per hour each. Clean post-industrial plastics are regranulated without washing. The final regranulate after cold homogenization is packaged in big bags per ton. In a separate workshop, rigid plastics such as cans, buckets, sheets, sprues and lumps are processed. In another separate crushing workshop, solid industrial waste is recycled. Well, and how without its own laboratory and quality control? On a corporate video, this is always our people in white coats in sterile rooms. In real life, it's a little simpler, but still great enough. Quality control begins right in the locker room, just because there are a lot of wash basins and water here. The managing director himself does this very often. Visual inspection is carried out, color, smell, and buoyancy are checked. melt flow index is measured in a separate room, and there is also a mini extruder, a mini injection molding machine, and a mini blow film extruder. And attention, a mini blown film sample is made out of the regranulate of each big bag and placed in a special pocket. To summarize, what are the key business model features? Highly automated and mechanized recycling process. Only new and constantly upgraded machines. Investments in machinery are at least 10-12 million euros only for this plant. The widest possible range of processed raw materials, and the raw materials are sold in any form for which there is a demand, in bales, in regrind, in regranulate. Large modern facilities with dust controls and wastewater treatment systems. And of course, the key is also a big sales volume, which is more than 12,000 tons a month, and up to 90% probably of it could be the materials which were just resold without any or with minimum processing. Now we are in Kampen at Brink Recycling. This family business is over 50 years old, with last 20 years in the plastic recycling. The current owner, Arno Brink, runs the company with his family. They are the main, or maybe the only, employees of the company. And this is an indispensable attribute of such small firms. Only by doing almost everything with your own hands, you can keep costs as on minimum level and survive in the competition. Recycling volume is up to 500 tons per month, and again, many is just reselling. Specialization is HDP rigid plastics. Recycling process is carried out by several technological options, by mini cycles. The main product is a mixed HDP regrind, out of containers, drums, cans, bottles, barrels, etc. For this kind of product, the technological process is as follows. Raw materials are crushed on this shredder, passed through this sink float tank, and additionally crushed with a granulator to a fraction of 12 millimeters. That's it.
This machine will go outside. I have a big hopper here.
The moisture of the output is still high, more than 10%. The percent of impurities, such as LDP, PP and PET, is also still high, up to 20%, but there is already demand for such a product. There are all sorts of containers, which are partially resold after manual washing and partially crushed and included in the mix of colored HDP, which we talked about earlier. They process up to 100 tons monthly of automated fuel tanks. These are black large pieces. These are tanks after shredding on this two shaft shredder. They don't wash it, but sell it like that. Part of the highly pure raw materials is regranulated on an old Arema, but not more than 20-30 tons per month. There is also some WEEE, waste of electric and electronic equipment. It is crushed on the same two-shaft shredder, additionally crushed on this granulator, and then separated on a densimetric separator of its own manufacture. The plastic is separated from non-ferrous metals. Here's how it works. Thank you.
Which side plastic go?
Both sides. This way.
Plastic go this way. Plastic go back side.
Yeah, and then copper will go this side.
And copper go forward. And aluminium?
Also. You can see here.
With aluminium.
Aluminium is going here. Aluminium copper. See here.
Aluminium with copper go here.
Yeah.
Interesting. Very simple, right? And the plastic goes here. That's how you collect the plastic?
Here on this side, it goes through the conveyor on this side. Double bottom. Let's go here and here. You compress it. Looks spectacular.
Sales go mainly to Southeast Asia also, for irrigation pipes for instance, and other applications. They sell a color mix of HDP and black HDP. As a result, we can see that such a business model of small enterprise in plastic recycling is also possible in Europe due to the following features. Minimum employees costs, the owner and members of this family do almost everything themselves. Old and long-running equipment that is some of that self-made, repaired and adapted. Batch processing for the order. There is no continuous round-the-clock process of recycling here. Processing is carried out in batches as raw materials arrive and an order from the buyer. Processing of raw materials is done in the minimum necessary volume, only coarse grinding, as in the case of fuel tanks, or even only manual washing, as in the case of containers. Operators are moving from one piece of equipment to another. Well, another important factor is that all buildings and facilities have long been in family ownership. There are no rental payments. Moreover, the whole family lives right here. In this hangar, there is a kind of loft is arranged, where there is even a room with the owner's hunting trophies.